Town Portal is, in my opinion, one of the greatest instrumental bands of our time. I'm going to take you through three excerpts from their song Uncle Genie that showcase the band's ability to apply their knowledge of polyrhythms and odd time signatures, all while maintaining a strong sense of musicianship. Download the free PDF for this demonstration in the description below. The first excerpt that we are going to look at is from 134 to 156. This groove consists of a 4 against 5 polyrhythmic feel between the bass drum and the hi-hats. This means that for every 5 notes we play on the hi-hats, 4 bass drum notes will have occurred with even spacing. I strictly use the word feel here, only because the first and third measures of the phrase are a true 4 against 5 polyrhythm, whereas the second and fourth measures slightly deviate from that formula. However, I am not willing to rule out the possibility that when Town Portal originally began composing this section, the drummer started off with the part following a true 4 against 5 polyrhythm all the way through the phrase. While this section is written in 5-4, we are given the illusion of 4-4 due to the snare backbeat that occurs every fourth quarter note starting on beat 3 of the first measure of the phrase. Note that there is a measure of 3-4 separating the A and B sections from each other. The next excerpt occurs immediately after the previous example, starting at 156 and ending at 226. This is my favorite part of the song. In example A, we play a 4 against 3 polyrhythm between the bass drum and the hi-hats to set up the next repetition. This means that for every 3 notes we play on the hi-hats, 4 bass drum notes will have occurred with even spacing. It would be best to use this time to get a feel for the 2 bars of 6 and 1 bar of 9 that make up the whole phrase. In example B, we add a snare drum hit that occurs every 7th 16th note starting on beat 1 of the first measure of the phrase. This is where things start to get tricky. Considering that the snare drum hit happens in different spots of the 4 against 3 polyrhythm every single time that it repeats. Despite this chaos, it still grooves. Example C is the same as B, but with the addition of opening the hi-hats and adding some more crashes. Finally, we are going to look at the section that occurs from 344 to 435. This 11-4 groove features an 11-16 ostinato on the bass drum that accompanies the bass guitar. Similar to the first excerpt, we are given the illusion of 4-4 due to the snare drum hit occurring every other quarter note starting on beat 2 of the measure. The asterisk symbol below the staff notates where the 11-16 ostinato starts over within the measure. Note that it takes 4 repetitions of the 11-16 ostinato for it to begin on beat 1 again. If this selection from the song gives you too much trouble, the included PDF provides 3 additional steps to build up to it.